Hey Instagram, welcome to our weekly Q&A hangout session. This week we are talking all about how to get yourself on advanced reader copy teams. So we are talking all about ARC teams today, and we're going to talk about how you can get on them. So with ARC teams, what happens is you are gaining access to books before they are published, and these books are meant to be read and reviewed on release day, or read before and reviewed on release day. So the entire goal with an ARC team is for authors or publishers to give early copies of the books to readers so that on that day they can head over to Amazon, to Barnes & Noble, to iBooks, to Kobo, and leave reviews on that first date, because we know reviews are incredibly important to authors and publishers. If we don't have them, we can't buy ads, which means we cannot sell our books and make money the way that we should be. So if we don't have those early reviews, and a lot of them, it really does hurt detrimentally what we are trying to do as authors. So with these ARC teams, we are forming trusted groups of readers to read our books and then leave reviews on these platforms. They're not mandated to say anything. You should absolutely not be saying, "I was given this book in exchange for an honest review." You can't say that. You get flagged for that. Also, it's kind of illegal. So when you are doing this, you are reading, reviewing honestly, and you are posting them where you commit to posting them. So let's talk about how to get on these teams. If you're just jumping in, hello and welcome. Let me know where you're joining me from, and if you have been on an ARC team before, because we're going to give you best practices. Now, long before I was an author, I did book reviewing. So I worked with all the major companies, and I was getting tons of books before they came out to the public, like big name books. And so I know all the tips and tricks on how to get yourself implemented into these ARC team systems and really best practices for it. So we are going to be talking about that today, and I would love to hear from you if you have been involved. So when it comes to ARC teams, we are really building up trusted teams of people who are going to be posting those reviews. If you take on a bunch of books and you're not posting these reviews, people are going to stop trusting you. So definitely one of the main things is that you have to be a trustworthy person. And it is not for you to be posting like on a personal blog or on Goodreads or like places that don't really help authors. These are specifically for the buying platforms. So we want you to post on Amazon, on Barnes & Noble, on the big buying platforms, and then on your social media as well. So keep that in mind when you're thinking about doing something like this. When you commit to this, you are given an amount of time. Sometimes it's a couple weeks, sometimes it's a couple months, depends on when they're doing it. And you are committing to reading it by the day that it is dropped. So the day it releases, you do need to have it read and post your review by. If you don't, that means you're kind of not holding up your end of the deal. Even if it's, you know, a week late, that's problematic. So you have to make sure it's, you've got space and time in your calendar for doing this when you take on these books, and don't take on too many. Start very, very slow. Now, if you haven't been paying attention to my social media on TikTok and on Instagram, I've dropped some names of different groups that you can get involved in, like NetGalley, where you can get those books early and you can request to have certain books. But you can also, and this is a much better plan, you can also go directly to the authors and publishers. So you are going to want to reach out to them. Some people have information on their website, some people have information on their social media. Sometimes you have to email them and say, "Do you have an ARC team? I would like information on being on it." And that means you're going to have to reach out to them. That's what I want to really talk about today. But if you've got questions and comments along the way, please go ahead and drop those down below. I would love to get them answered for you, because you know I've got a million books and tons of experience in this industry, and I want to get these questions answered for you. You've been on an ARC team before. I don't think I've officially been on an ARC team, but I've definitely read ARCs for several authors. Fabulous. So when it comes to reaching out to these authors, if they have a big name publisher, you're probably going to need to go to the publisher. The author probably will not be responding to all of their emails, or their publicist will not be responding to emails. They'll direct you over to the company. So if it's a big name house, you can definitely go there. Otherwise, you can probably go directly to the author. If it's anything but like the big five, I would go directly to the author and either definitely check their website first, but then you want to make sure you are emailing them if you can't find information. So specifically, you want to say something along the lines of, "I am a fan of your books. I would love the chance to read an early copy for a review, or I would like to be on your review team. I would love to be on your ARC team. Can you send me information or direct me to the proper place to learn more about your ARC team process?" And the author will then either send you information about that. If they don't have one, they might let you know that, or they might send you over to their publisher if that's something that goes through the publisher. But most medium and small-sized publishers are typically hands off with that, and they go through the author, or the author can connect you properly. And if you go through the author, you have a better chance of being accepted. Now, like I said, for being accepted, you do have to, you know, promise that you're going to do it on time. You do have to show that you have done this kind of thing before. So whatever books you've read, go leave reviews on Amazon. Have a track record of leaving quality reviews. That doesn't mean they have to be good, positive reviews. It means quality reviews that help other people make decisions on whether or not they are going to pick up that book. And if you need help on that, I have YouTube videos on how to write quality book reviews. I also have the book review journal to help you do it, so you don't even have to think it through. So you can grab that and go right through it. You can check out the free video as well. And you need to have that track record. So show that you are actively posting reviews specifically on Amazon and things like Barnes & Noble and Kobo, because those are the ones that actually help authors. And when you show that you have that track record of actually holding up your end of the deal, they're much more likely to give you these books. That's why I had access to big name books that, by the way, were turned into movies. And I had it in my hands like months before it came out to the public, and you can do that as well. So you want to make sure you're reaching out to that author, unless they're like with the big five publishers, and then go directly to them. You may or may not get access to them. With those bigger publishers, you typically don't get access until you have a really good track record. So just be aware you're not going to get the big name ones right off the bat, but you will be able to build yourself up with that. And you want to just make sure you're sending a short, sweet email. I like your books. Especially if you say that you like the books, like, go to your favorite authors, books that you've already read that you enjoy, and let them know, I'm a fan of yours. I would love to be able to do this with you and to help you out on this, and they'll be able to send you information if that's something that they have to give you. Riley does want to know, once you're part of an ARC team, do you stay on it? That entirely depends on how you have formed that relationship with them. So if you are part of an ARC team and they have a set structure, they've got some type of group on Facebook or Discord, then you are, once you're in, you're probably going to stay in. You might need to earn your way up in the ranks. You may even need to earn your place within that team. But if you go to them on one specific book, that is very likely just specific to that book, and you'll have to go back to them again. So let's say you have come to me because you knew that I dropped a copy of The Conspiracy of Jack Frost recently, and you came and you were an early copy reader for me, and you came specific about this book, and I gave you a copy of just that specific book. That does not mean you're on my ARC team. It means you read and reviewed a book for me. You would need to come back and be a part of the team for that. But if you came to me and said, I would like to work with you in the future in an ongoing capacity to review your books, then you're on the team, and it's not necessarily specific to one book. Just because you're a part of a team doesn't mean you have to read every book within that group. I have been in the past, before I was an author, I've worked with publishers and I was in their ARC group, and then I could pick and choose which books I wanted. And you want to make sure that you're not taking on too many books. If you take on too many books, you're going to fall behind and not be able to handle it, and then you're going to get yourself kicked out of the group for not doing the work. So you have to make sure you hold up your end of the commitment. And if anything comes up, you need to be able to tell them some emergency came up, I'm going to be a little late. Keep them posted, because if they get to release day and you have not posted your reviews, that could very likely get you kicked out of the group for not holding up your end of the deal. So if something is coming up, contact them and tell them that it is something that is happening, and you just want to make sure that they know that you are working on it, but you just had an emergency, whatever it happened to be, and make sure it's a valid excuse, not that I forgot, because that'll get you kicked out, but something really did come up to prevent it. And then start slow. One book at a time. Do not take on another book until you have that book done. Once you kind of establish yourself with how you're doing this, then you can take on, you know, two or three at once, and you know your plan and your schedule and how you're going to handle this, and you will be able to get it done. But at the beginning, do not take on another book until you finish the first one. Just don't do it, because you can get yourself in a lot of trouble if you slip a little bit, especially in the beginning stages of this. Now, if you have questions on ARC teams, now's a great time, because we're keeping this short today for the replay people, but I would love to get your questions answered about ARC teams. Best thing you can do is reach out to the author or the publisher and let them know that you have a track record, you've already posted reviews for other books, possibly theirs, possibly others, on places like Amazon and Barnes & Noble and Kobo and all those good things, that you do promote things on social media. That's going to be dramatically helpful to you on TikTok or on Instagram or on YouTube. You want to show that you are trustworthy and that you're excited for this opportunity and to spend time with their books and really help them to grow. And then you just have to wait back. Most people will respond to you, and they will give you information or tell you it's not open right now. Some of them will not, and you just have to be okay with that. Do not throw a temper tantrum because somebody didn't respond to you or somebody is not letting you into a team for whatever reason. You have to be respectful in the industry because other people are watching. And be aware that people will also look at your reviews to see how you're doing. If you're holding up your end of the deal, if you're writing good quality reviews, all those good things. And authors and publishers will seek people out. They do go and look at reviews on Amazon. And if you are someone who is actively reviewing, they may contact you because you've read similar books and they think that you're going to like theirs. So once you start doing this more, you will actually get invited. You will not have to ask. You will get invited to come do all these really cool things. And if you're struggling with finding authors and publishers that you are able to work with, you can do something like go over to NetGalley, create an account over there, and you can start requesting books there, and you'll get approved and denied for books there so that you can get started with this. But even if you don't have access to ARCs right now, the best thing you can do is to take any book that you've read in the past and go write a quality review for it, put it on all the things, and start marketing them. That is how you're going to get noticed, and that's how you're going to get ranked higher inside of these ARC teams so that you're getting more privileges faster, you're getting more things, and these are all ebooks. People are not going to give you physical books if you don't have a massive platform. So now that you're starting to build up your platform, once you have a big TikTok or a big YouTube or a big Instagram where people are listening to your recommendations and going and buying books based off of what you're saying, then they're going to start to send you physical books because it's worth that investment that they have to pay for these books and to ship them to you early. And that's not cheap, guys. Once you have built up that platform where you have people actively listening to your recommendations and taking action on them and buying the books that you're saying to buy, you're going to get more and more physical books and swag and extra things and like all the good stuff. So if you want to build yourself up to that point, start now with these ARC teams, start with the ebooks, take any ones that you can get, really leave good quality book reviews. Remember, I had that free training over on YouTube, also the book review journal that literally walks you through it. So all you have to do is fill in the blanks for your reviews. It's right there for you and done and ready to go, and you can move forward with this process of getting involved in different ARC teams and reaching out to different authors and publishers so that you can get those advanced copies of books and read all the good things before they come out to the public. And all you gotta do is leave those good reviews and help market the books. Sounds pretty good, right? It's definitely a fun experience, and when you do it with friends, you can really do some cool things. You can do buddy reading, like all the good stuff. You can talk about it before anybody else can talk about it. And you get to make friends on these teams as well. So if you are not somebody who has like a lot of bookish friends to talk about books with, join an ARC team. You will find people who are reading the same early copies of books as you. And then you'll be able to talk about them weeks to months before these books come out. It's a really fun way to grow your community and grow your platform and get those books early. All right, friends, thank you so much for joining me today. I appreciate you being here and hanging out on Instagram as we talked all about how to join those ARC teams. If you have more questions, I would love to get them answered for you. We are here every Tuesday doing our weekly hangouts at 3 p.m. Eastern. And for those of you who have not been paying attention, over on the Likewise app, we're hosting an author Q&A with Eliza Tilton today. Make sure you go check that out. And I'm dropping not one, but two writing competitions over the next couple of days, probably this week and maybe next week or the following week for the second one. The first one has a $150 prize. The second one gets your book published. So it's really cool. It's very exciting. I cannot wait to tell you all about these. The first contest information does drop on Thursday, so 2 days from now. And then the second competition that I'm in charge of and I'm doing the cool stuff for, that one's going to be dropped probably next week. We're giving it a little space so you have time to do both of these things, but it's going to be good. So stay tuned. Big things coming. I will see you in the next live stream here on Instagram. Make sure you go leave some love to my Instagram reels because Instagram just pushed their reels. If you've noticed, down on the bottom, they now have a reels button where the post your content button used to be. That means it's important. So go leave some love on my reels. I'll see you all in the next episode. Until then, friends, have a great day and stay inspired.